On the other hand, there are a lot of Trump cultists. These people support Trump no matter what he does or says. They give excuses for everything that he does or says, no matter what it is. Most recently for brainstorming about injecting and ingesting disinfectants. They'll say, Trump didn't command people to inject bleach. He was just brainstorming. Completely denying that during this pandemic, there are a lot of very desperate people out there that are looking for answers. There's also a lot of very stupid people out there, too. Poison control centers received quite a few calls regarding disinfectants. Whether or not Trump was stupid enough to think that this could be something worth looking into, the idea of injecting or ingesting disinfectants should never have been said aloud. People saying, well, it's not Trump's fault for people being stupid enough to actually do something like that. Actually, it is. If Trump wouldn't have said it, they wouldn't have done it. I mean, period. He's the president of the United States. He should be more careful of his statements. Or his brainstorming. It reminds me of when huge YouTubers would make fun of people with really tiny channels, like, I mean, some channels that have less than 50 subscribers, and these huge YouTubers would do ponage on them. I mean, sometimes for valid things, but sometimes just making fun of their appearance or making fun of a bunch of other things that aren't very productive. And people would swarm that smaller YouTuber's channel with negative comments, and people would say, well, it's not the bigger YouTuber's fault. Yeah, it is. If that YouTuber wouldn't have said that, they wouldn't have gotten swarmed. It's as simple as that. And when it comes to Trump's brainstorming of injecting and ingesting disinfectants, Trump tried to get out of it by essentially saying that he was just trolling. Yeah, like that makes it any better. But to Trump cultists, it's okay for a sitting president of the United States to troll the public during a pandemic. Then there's Trump's tweets that are too numerous to really pick out one as being the worst. Trump cultists will defend every one of them. We shouldn't be in a situation where supporting the president is considered rebellious. But here we are. Society is flipped upside down. People are honestly having a hard time telling wrong from right. And considering that mainstream media has chosen Biden, the sexual assaulter with mental deterioration, as the primary candidate to run against Trump, yeah, we're probably going to get Trump for 4 more years. Thanks, mainstream media. I don't know if our society can take it, honestly. We'll just have to see, right?